హలో, ఐఎమ్ డాక్టర్ వరుణ్ రాజు తిరుమలగిరి. ఐఎమ్ ఏ సీనియర్ మినిమల్ యాక్సెస్ సర్జన్ అండ్ జనరల్ సర్జన్ అండ్ బేరియాట్రిక్ సర్జన్ అట్ ఓమ్ని హాస్పిటల్ కూకట్పల్లి. సో ద మినిమల్ యాక్సెస్ సర్జరీ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో నోన్ యాజ్ మినిమల్లీ ఇన్వేసివ్ సర్జరీ అండ్ లాపరోస్కోపిక్ సర్జరీ, కీహోల్ సర్జరీ ఆర్ బటన్ హోల్ సర్జరీ. ఇట్ హెస్ గాట్ సో మెనీ నేమ్స్ అండ్ ఇట్ హెస్ గాట్ అ వెరీ లాంగ్ హిస్టరీ రిగార్డింగ్ ఇట్స్ డెవలప్మెంట్ యాజ్ ఏ మినిమల్ యాక్సెస్ సర్జరీ. నౌ ఇట్ ఈస్ వెరీ పాపులర్ అండ్ ఫేమస్ ఫ్రమ్ 1980s, వేర్ ఇట్ హెస్ టేకన్ ఎ వెరీ స్టీప్ డెవలప్మెంట్ యాజ్ ద లాపరోస్కోపిక్ సర్జరీ ఈజ్ ద గోల్డ్ స్టాండర్డ్ సర్జరీ రైట్ నౌ. ఎవ్రీబడి నోస్ అబౌట్ ఇట్. లైక్ ఫర్ గాల్ స్టోన్స్ ద సర్జరీ విచ్ ఈస్ బీయింగ్ డన్ ఈస్ ద కొలిసిస్ టెక్టమీ. ప్రీవియస్లీ ఇట్ వాస్ డన్ లైక్ ఓపెన్ సర్జరీ, లైక్ ఎ బిగ్ ఇన్సిషన్, లైక్ 10-15 centimeters ఆఫ్ ఇన్సిషన్ ఎట్ ద రైట్ సైడ్ ఆఫ్ అబ్డోమెన్. నౌ ఇట్ ఈస్ బీయింగ్ డన్ విత్ స్మాల్ టైనీ ఇన్స్ట్రుమెంట్స్, లైక్ 0.5 centimeter ఇన్స్ట్రుమెంట్స్ ఆర్ 1 centimeter ఇన్స్ట్రుమెంట్ విత్ టెలిస్కోప్ అండ్ మానిటరింగ్ సిస్టమ్. అండ్ దెర్ ఈస్ ఎ పర్టికులర్ మెథడాలజీ ఆఫ్ డూయింగ్ మినిమల్ యాక్సెస్ సర్జరీ ఆర్ లాపరోస్కోపిక్ సర్జరీ, వేర్ టార్గెటెడ్ డిజీజ్డ్ ఆర్గన్స్ ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు బి రిమూవ్డ్. లైక్ ఇట్స్ లైక్ జస్ట్ లైక్ ఓపెన్ సర్జరీ, ఓపెన్ సర్జికల్ ప్రొసీజర్, బట్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఈస్ డన్ ఇన్ ఎ వెరీ మినిమల్ యాక్సెస్ వే. ద అడ్వాంటేజెస్ ఆర్ వెరీ సింపుల్. ఇట్ ఈస్ వెరీ వెల్ టెస్టెడ్ అండ్ దెర్ ఈస్ లాట్ ఆఫ్ సైంటిఫిక్ అక్యుములేషన్ వేర్ the laparoscopy is compared to open surgery, and it is known that the laparoscopic surgery has got many advantages compared to open surgery. Per se, it is not superior to the open surgery. Both are equal in the sense open is a gold standard treatment for many surgeries. But because of this development of imaging system, lenses like scopes, we use the telescopes and as well as the monitoring system where the HD has come into the picture. And there are so many instruments are designed where with a small incision, the bigger surgeries can be done very easily. So it actually started with the gynecological procedures, but gradually gone into the general surgery, abdominal surgeries. Now the minimal access surgery or laparoscopic surgery is also being done in all other specialties like surgical oncology, urology, gynecology, and so many departments. So minimal access in the sense it is a minimally invasive procedure. For an example, if you go for appendicectomy, we need to open it and cut all the muscles and go and get the small tubular structure appendix through that big incision. So there will be pain and as well as the bleeding chances, and also we put much efforts to close all the musculature and as well as the skin with multiple stitches. So there is a chance of stitch infection or wound infection in open surgery. And the same appendix is going to be removed by the umbilicus by putting small instruments in minimal access surgery. The advantages of minimal access surgery or laparoscopic surgery is the early recovery. Patient can go home within about 48 hours and he can attend to the job within 3 days. Nowadays, all this modern era, everybody wants a job without any leave or something like that, because there will be loss of payment for that. And also there is less requirement of drugs like antibiotics and analgesics in laparoscopic surgery. And wound chances are very less. And there is a very small scar which is seen in laparoscopic surgery compared to open surgery. Nowadays, the development of minimal access surgery has gone into in next further steps, like it has gone into 3D laparoscopy, micro laparoscopy, and robotic laparoscopic surgeries, which are being performed in many parts of the world. Especially these robotic surgeries are very popular when there are corners of our human body surgeries, like prostate, pelvic surgeries, or thoracic surgery, or thyroid surgeries. Thyroid, you know that it is there in front of the neck. So in robotic thyroidectomies, like in minimally access surgery of thyroid surgery, so there is no need to open the neck. There is no need to give an incision to open the neck to remove the thyroid gland. So this is happening nowadays with the robotic surgeries. And also now the minimal access surgery has gone into another level by like telesurgeries, in the sense a surgeon who is sitting at some other part can able to perform the laparoscopic surgery by using the signaling system, but that is still it is in the premature state. it takes a lot of time for the development and proper studies on that particular aspect. As a whole, now if you see any procedure, if you are searching in the Google or YouTube, if you type a particular procedure what you are interested, now all the procedures which comes in forward to you are the laparoscopic surgery or minimal access. At the end, I would like to speak a small point about the disadvantages of laparoscopy. Laparoscopy surgery requires a lot of experience and learning curve will be there. Laparoscopy has got basic laparoscopy and advanced laparoscopic surgery. In advanced laparoscopic surgeries, you require more skills, more experience, expertise. When laparoscopy is not performed properly, there are chances of injury to the other parts of the body is not properly done. So, even if the laparoscopy is difficult, if there is a bleeding or if you cannot able to dissect the desired organ properly, and you should always inform to the patient at the time of beginning of the surgery with a consent that there is a chance of opening of the abdomen. So it's called as a conversion. So any laparoscopic surgery, you have to explain to the patient that there is a chance of conversion to open. So you should not think that laparoscopy is failed if you open the same procedure. But the main goal is to save the patient's life and to treat the patient's pathology. Overall, there is a lot of research which is going on about so many aspects of the laparoscopic surgery. And I would conclude that now the laparoscopy is gold standard for gallbladder surgeries, inguinal hernia surgeries, incisional hernia surgeries, and bowel surgeries. The most common bowel surgery nowadays, which is performed in laparoscopic surgery, is a bariatric surgery. In the sense, the patient is going to be treated with a bariatric surgery to reduce the weight of the patient in obesity. This obesity is now increasing steeply in the society by so many factors like food habits, junk foods, and not doing any exercise and other issues. So all the bariatric surgeries are being performed by laparoscopic surgery. The success rate of laparoscopic surgery depends upon the surgeon's experience, and the complications and other things are same like open surgeries. Whatever may be the procedure, if the complications are expected in open surgery are equal to laparoscopic surgery. The advantages of laparoscopic surgery, already I said, early recovery, less drugs, less chances of infection, and they can go to job early and very small scar. Overall, his comfort levels are very, very much better than the open surgery. The best control for the obesity surgery, the best control measures or the methods is the awareness to the people in the public by so many angles, like your media and other things. The best thing is you should know what are the calories which are there when you are eating some food, calorie counting. Chocolate appears very small, but it has got a lot of calories. Avoiding sugar is very important. Taking a fiber-rich diet is very important. Taking fruits, reducing the refined foods in the sense fried foods and sweets and cakes. And ultimately, the advice is you have to count your calories while you are consuming it so that you can prevent your obesity. Do the regular exercise, take more fiber rich diet, better you have more days of vegetarian food. You can make your non-vegetarian at one day, or better not to take it if you don't like it. Food is main important thing in reducing the obesity, and the second one is doing the regular exercises. It is preferable to have a trainer so that you can easily measure that how many kilograms you have reduced after a specular or a particular time period, like say after 1 week or 1 month or six months, like that. Physical trainer is very important, doing exercises and as well as reducing the food calories, that is most important. If it is not possible, then you have to go for all the investigations. Like there are certain genetical issues which are also there in obesity, and there are certain endocrine problems like thyroid and other issues are there. So you go for all the clinical tests, get it checked up, and you can show to the physician so that that particular disease is going to be treated, and obesity also may be controlled with that particular medical management. After a trial of all these things, so if it is not possible to reduce the weight and if the BMI is more than 40, then it is better to go for a bariatric surgery. Thank you.